Romina.
Yes.
We are your new restaurant in San Francisco. Oh my Romina.
Yes.
In the former space of Aqua. So you came back to your roots.
Yes.
You are Gallo's Restaurateur of the Year for 2011. Congratulations.
Thank you.
So tell me a little about the story of the restaurant. How did you, you know, get to that level that you're 2011 the restaurant? Gallo, what's your secret?
My secret, I don't know. Great people. Surround yourself with great people. I've been doing this for a long time, probably now. This restaurant is 20. I started this restaurant 20 years ago when it was Auckland. And so this is 2011. We opened up in 1991. I've opened 22 restaurants since then. But
yeah, a few of them have been.
What?
Just to say they're great. Yes.
But honestly, you know, this is where my heart is. This restaurant is something that will always be dear to me. And really, the spot you're standing in right now, I've stood in this spot for 12 years, for, you know, 8 to 10 hours a day, standing right here in this kitchen, and this is home.
So you did you need a new decor in the restaurant?
I did.
It's upscale, but it's more simple in a way that there's like no tablecloths on the tables.
Well, the challenge of this restaurant to me was, you take a restaurant that opened in 1991, but honestly, I feel it's the most beautiful restaurant in San Francisco for many years, 15 years, and you say now, how do you think, you know, I had a chance to take something that really had been a landmark in San Francisco, and then try and bring it more into the times of what fine dining is, you know, kind of where fine dining has gone, and fine dining has gone to a certain sensibility of comfort, but still keeping it very chic.
Right, which is exactly, if I would have summarized the next restaurant that you stole the word out of my mouth, that's exactly what it is.
Great.
So on top of this gorgeous food, you have gorgeous plates. Look, one that they're handmade,
yes,
just for you, one by one, and you don't have only one supplier, you've got many suppliers, and they're even packed in the kitchen. Yes. This is that plate is only for crab, that was only for chicken dog, this was only for beef, and it goes on and on and on, and there's still some more over there. I don't like to put a word favorite on the dishes that I have, but one of them was serving to
five C's.
So describe that to me.
Well, you actually had because you did a tasty menu, we gave you a 3 C's instead of 5. Instead of 5 fish, we gave you 3 fish.
I knew something was missing there.
But the idea is really, it's a Japanese influence dish. And, you know, I love Japanese cooking because of the technique and simplicity to it, but the really bold flavors. And so that particular dish, the plate that was designed, we actually did the dish first and then designed the plate in a way that we could lay out 5 fish, 5 completely different techniques.
So how do you get the influences? You're not from Asia, you're from the other side. How do you get from here? You're from Egypt, so how do you get all, you know, from there to come all the way to here and to get all this, you know, how do you integrate this Asian culture into your cooking?
Well, I'm a very big fan of Japanese food, and I always have. I love it. Studied it, love to eat it. And, you know, really just taking techniques and flavors that I understand and putting them together.
Well done. We had some, tell us what I mean. We had duck.
You had duck with foie gras, stuffed kumquat, a little brinto with a duck, with a duck-like confit, the roasted duck, and the foie gras itself. And, you know, again, something that became pretty famous for up the hill is taking, you know, one product and doing it in many different techniques, and that's something that we still like
and
to show.
What was the next course we had? My guessing next to me on my right just loved the next course.
You actually had a fun play on beef, really. It's a braised beef short rib and a fillet, but you have it really taking a horseradish flavor. Horseradish and Brussels sprouts are cooked in red wine, and two versions of Brussels sprouts, one cooked in red wine, one just simply the leaves, and then horseradish, the tan that's over the fillet, and then a little bit of
it was a delightful dinner and congratulations, because as of today, you have 18 restaurants in operation, right?
Yes.
So it's a big operation, and I know there's a, I go to your places in different cities all the time, and there's a level of quality. quality of service, and I mean, I would say food first and service and decor that not too many chefs can sustain throughout the U.S. Italian place. So, for your restaurant earlier, thank you so much, Michael.
Thank you. Appreciate it.